Hey guys, and welcome to the show. Today is movie review. I know, right? I love the summer, and I love these movies. I love going to the movies. Do you like going to the movies?
Yeah.
And I love being, like, recording in a bouncy car so that it does this. This is so much fun. All right, Hailey, what are we going to see today?
Anna.
Anna Banana? This looks like a strange movie. This looks like a cross between, like, La Femme Nikita and Red Scorpion or whatever. What was the one with the Hunger Games chick? Do you remember that one? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So you know what I'm talking about, right? Okay, so like that one, and then like the story for Scarlett Johansson's character.
Lucy?
Yeah. Well, no, they haven't made it yet, but Natasha, they're filming it right now for Avengers. You know,
oh, she's getting her own movie.
Yeah, she's getting her own movie. This kind of seems like it's going to be something along those lines where it's like some trained operative female killer. I don't know. Looks cool though, right?
Yeah.
You excited? It's nothing like summer vacation. Up all night party! Which means basically just sitting on your bed watching YouTube videos.
Maybe.
Did you bring the chips?
I brought the chips. I secured the bag.
So I don't know how many of you guys grew up in the, I'm just going to call it the lower income housing. I did. My mom, three kids, single. Doesn't matter. But we would sneak in soda, chips,
whole meal.
There'd be like a chicken in the bag. You know.
We'd stop at the Dollar Tree before we went to the movie.
Yeah.
Whatever you want.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. Trust me, don't get me wrong. But as a kid that grew up doing that and eating free lunches, when I was old enough to go to the movies and like buy a popcorn, then I appreciated the fact of why she did that. Because God, jeez, oh man. $14-15 for a popcorn and a drink? Jeez.
And honestly, your own food that you bring is better, at least I think.
It's more healthy.
No. That's not what I was better as in. I like this food better.
More yummy.
Yeah.
Ooh, you got the Fago Brave. Ginger ale with lemon. Is it pizza? Is it chicken fingers?
It's none of the above.
It's just barbecue chicken. What the heck? Same thing with veggies. Yummy.
I compared it to Lucy too.
Yeah?
Yeah, finally the old man and I agree on something.
So the gatekeeper to the video, apparently after 3 weeks of coming here, is now our buddy. Because he was giving us like movie reviews. Dude, it's a good movie. Ooh, that's it right there. Want to go see that?
I said that in the last video.
I'm going to edit it out. Do you know where we're going?
We already played the video. It came out today. Good luck. Oh, my stomach hurts.
Did you have too much rice?
No, that rice was so bad.
You didn't like the rice?
No. It
smelled like somebody farted. Did you smell that too?
It's probably you.
It wasn't me.
Heyo.
Oh. Is that the seat?
Yeah. Oh my God.
What's that?
I have money.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this time you actually have money? Whoa.
Four buckaroonies.
Ooh, making it rain.
Ooh, these ones are crisp.
Helping your mom fund and save with Progressive. But hey, we're all in this together.
He talks to himself.
Right, champ?
Good
morning.
Like
he's snoring.
Kids, get out of my yard. Okay, Anna. What can I say?
It was kind of confusing.
It was super confusing. I mean, but, okay, it was weird because it was confusing, but then they explained everything, but then it was confusing again, but then they explained it, but then it was confusing. And by the time at the end, you're like, I don't know what the hell's going on.
Yeah. She, like, quadruple cross everyone.
It's a spy movie. Oh yeah, I should say spoilers.
If you're not used to it by now.
It is definitely R, and it's a hard R in more ways than one. There was a lot of these scenes. Don't do this.
Said before, don't bring your kids.
Definitely don't bring your kids to see this one, no matter how hard you want to. There was, four or five action sequences? Maybe four good action sequences? I mean, once they let her loose, it was like John Wick.
I thought that too.
Yeah, it was like a female John Wick. So once they let her loose, and those the scenes that she had where she was just like going crazy, female John Wick, awesome. The actress that played her did an amazing job with it. I mean, it was totally believable. Unbelievable, totally believable. The other scenes in the movie, like the movie had a lot of story, right? I mean, is that what you call it?
Sure.
I mean, there was a plot. It was a young girl that was trying to get her freedom in a world that just didn't want to give it to her.
Yeah, really.
And she was really smart, and she figured out how to get it, and she got it. Oh, and there's the ending. Tons of action, tons of downtime. There's a lot of playing around. I mean, what would you consider? Would you give a thumbs up? Kind of like in the middle? Okay, John Wick.
What were you gonna say?
I say compare it to John Wick 3. Better or worse?
Better.
Okay, and I'll agree with that because there was actually a story here that they were trying to tell, which is something that they missed totally in John Wick 3. There was no story. It was just like, hey.
It was kind of bad.
Yeah. Yeah, it was too much action. This is like the right amount of action versus story. Almost a little too much story. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, it was just like, if you weren't like actually watching, you'd be very lost. Which is kind of annoying, because I don't really like things where you have to like...
Which is
make
funny.
Make sure you have... Okay, like, I like it, but that much was just a little too much.
Well, I mean, right now you're watching How to Get Away with Murder.
Different.
Is it though?
Yes.
Because I feel like this was a lot.
That's like good. Okay, How to Get Away with Murder is like a murder mystery, and I'm into that kind of thing.
Well, this was a killer mystery.
I'm not into that.
All right, so you love the action.
Yeah.
The plot, a little too confusing for you.
The plot was good.
It was a good plot.
Like, you're here, take it to here. Take it down a notch.
Oh, we can say it's better than John Wick. We're not even going to compare it to last week's movie because Shaft was just a comedy.
Comparison.
Yeah, that was just funny. We actually had a good time with that one. So I'm going to give this one better than John Wick. So John Wick was good. This one is better. If you liked John Wick, definitely go see this because you won't be disappointed. Fair assessment? Or would you be disappointed? You tell me. Give me your opinion.
Wait, sorry. I wasn't listening. They flashed and I was listening.
I said if you like John Wick, you'll like this. Do you agree?
Yeah. Since John Wick wasn't that good, you'll have high hopes for this one. Oh, God. We got another one.
I don't know. It's just like there's only like 10 cars in the parking lot. I don't know how you can't find yours. People honking their horns.
Us.
Well, yeah, we walked to the totally wrong car, but we were also...
We walked to where I parked last time.
Yeah, you were arguing with me, so... Let's do thumbs up. I'm going one thumbs up on this one. Even though I know I gave John Wick 2 thumbs up, I'm taking one back, and I'm giving this one... This, so like John Wick was kind of here. This one is kind of here. All right. So there we go. Those are probably the only action movies you're going to get to see this summer. I don't think there's anything else coming out until August.
Sorry.
We have good one. Teached you well. In August, we have the.
You teached me well.
It took you a minute
I
to catch
you. Well.
No, I teached you well. We're going to end this one.
Ooh.
Yes.
I need to do this because I keep forgetting.
Go ahead.
Shout out to the Rush family.
Yeah.
Especially Macy, Maddie, Taylor, and Kyle.
A good one on getting Dora the Explorer from the other day. Alright, Hailey, end the show.
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
And if there's a movie you think we should check out, let us know. It doesn't have to be new. We're down with staying at home and renting a movie, so if you've got a favorite movie you'd like us to watch and talk about, I'm game. Let us know. You guys have a good night as always. We'll see you later next time.